Magandang araw, kapamilya. Today is Thursday of the 24th week in Ordinary Time. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Give peace, O Lord, to those who wait for you, that your prophets be found true. Hear the prayers of your servant and of your people, Israel.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. Look upon us, O God, Creator and Ruler of all things, that you may feel the working of your mercy. Grant that you may serve you with all our heart. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. I am reminding you, brothers and sisters, of the gospel I preached to you, which you indeed received and in which you also stand. Through it, you are also being saved, if you hold fast to the word I preached to you, unless you believed in vain. For I handed on to you as of first importance what I also received, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the Scriptures, that he was buried, and that he was raised on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures, that he appeared to Cephas, then to the 12. After that, he appeared to more than 500 brothers at once, most of whom are still living, though some have fallen asleep. After that, he appeared to James, then to all the apostles. Last of all, as to one born abnormally, he appeared to me. For I am the least of the apostles, not fit to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God. But by the grace of God, I am what I am, and his grace to me has not been ineffective. Indeed, I have toiled harder than all of them. Not I, however, but the grace of God that is with me. Therefore, whether it be I or they, so we preach and so you believed. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Let our response be, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his mercy endures forever. Let the house of Israel say, his mercy endures forever.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord has struck with power. I shall not die, but live, and declare the works of the Lord.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good.
You are my God, and I give thanks to you. O my God, I extol you.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. Alleluia, alleluia. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest, says the Lord. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
A certain Pharisee invited Jesus to dine with him, and he entered the Pharisee's house and reclined at table. Now there was a sinful woman in the city who learned that he was at table in the house of the Pharisee. Bringing an alabaster flask of ointment, she stood behind him at his feet weeping and began to bathe his feet. Then she wiped them with her hair, kissed them, and anointed them with the ointment. When the Pharisee who had invited him saw this, he said to himself, if this man were a prophet, he would know who and what sort of woman this is who is touching him, that she is a sinner. Jesus said to him in reply, Simon, I have something to tell you. "Tell me, teacher," he said. "Two people were in debt to a certain creditor. One owed 500 days' wages and the other owed 50. Since they were unable to repay the debt, he forgave it for both. Which of them will love him more?" Simon said in reply, "The one, I suppose, whose larger debt was forgiven." He said to him, "You have judged rightly." Then he turned to the woman and said to Simon, "Do you see this woman? When I entered your house, you did not give me water for my feet, but she bathed them with her tears and wiped them with her hair. You did not give me a kiss, but she has not ceased kissing my feet since the time I entered. You did not anoint my head with oil, but she anointed my feet with ointment. So I tell you, her many sins have been forgiven. Hence, she has shown great love. But the one to whom little is forgiven loves little." He said to her, "Your sins are forgiven." The others at table said to themselves, "Who is this who even forgives sins?" But he said to the woman, "Your faith has saved you. Go in peace." My dear brothers and sisters, the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Now, this gospel for today is a very interesting gospel. And let's try to look at the contrast between the Pharisee and then the woman. And just to see how much they differ. First of all, the Pharisee. Yeah, in the first place, you wonder why a Pharisee would invite Jesus to his house. And supposedly, he's a very wealthy Pharisee. And his house, supposedly, malaki, no? And yet, inimbita niya si Kristo, not because he wanted to know him, and not because he believed in him, but it was more, he wanted people to see that he could invite interesting people. It was more like that. Several commentaries of scripture commentaries would say that he invited Christ not for any noble purpose of knowing him or listening to him, but he just wanted to show that I can invite this popular rabbi. He is my guest. Whereas the sinful woman was there because of a very dire need for forgiveness. She really wanted to be with Christ. She really wanted to approach Christ to ask for forgiveness. So dun palang kitang-kita mo na yung pagkakaiba. Itong isa, napaka-impure ng kanyang dahilan kung ba't gusto niya makilala si Kristo o makasama si Kristo. Hindi man makilala, gusto lang niyang imbitahin sa bahay niya para mapasikat niya, no? Naimbita ko yung popular rabbi. Samantalang itong babae na napaka-makasalanan, kailangan niya yung pagpapatawad ni Kristo. So you see the differences in motivation. You see the differences in their desire to know Christ. One was a genuine desire to know Christ. One was simply to brag that he could invite Christ. So there you see the big contrast. Now the second contrast is the hospitality that they showed. You know, the tradition is when you welcome your guests, you wash their feet because, you know, it at that time it was dusty, everything, so you needed to wash their feet, no? And then, in fact, there's even a ritual of anointing, etc., as a sign of welcoming and a sign of really being your guest, no? But, you know, the Pharisee did not do any of that. And then the woman, sharp contrast again, she brings her bottle of perfume and washes the feet of Christ. And also, she wipes and washes the feet of Christ with her tears. She was just very moved because of that, and then wipes the feet with the hair. So for me, that is something that again, you see a very, very sharp contrast, no? In terms even of the hospitality. But of course, in the end, what you realize is that the woman was really someone who was asking for forgiveness and the humility to welcome Christ into her life. The humility to ask for forgiveness. Whereas the Pharisee was just totally out of it, so to speak. Makita ninyo na yung isa ay talagang, kumbaga, nauuhaw sa Panginoon. At yung isa naman ay wala siya talagang intensyon, wala siyang desire whatsoever na makilala at mapapasok ang Panginoon. I think this is something that it is important for us to reflect on. Of course, the main lesson of this gospel is that the forgiveness of sins are given to those who are most humble and contrite. That salvation comes to the humble. Salvation comes to the contrite. And it's interesting because in his spiritual exercises, one of the things you see in the spiritual exercises of Saint Ignatius of Loyola is that at the very end of the first week of the spiritual exercises, it closes with the forgiveness of sin. And you know, during that whole week, nagbi-build up lang yung ating pagkilala sa pagmamahal ng Diyos sa atin. Doon sa mga blessings, doon sa mga biyaya na binigay, at pagkatapos nun, papasok sa mga kasalanan na to make us feel sorry for our sins. In fact, Ignatius would build that up. He begins the first week of the spiritual exercises by, in a sense, soaking us in God's love, the gracious love of God. And then he makes us confront our sinfulness. And the whole point is that how could we have, in a sense, betrayed God, the God who gave us everything and loved us. And he makes us meditate and contemplate on our sins. But the genius of the process is that he brings that sinful, the contemplation and meditations on sin, he brings it to God's love. And there you have, I think, what is really the mood of this gospel. That here you have a woman who was totally contrite and remorseful, and yet trusted God's love, begged for God's love. And when you take a look at the dynamics of that sin and forgiveness, rooted and grounded in God's love in the spiritual exercises, it really becomes now a springboard for freedom. The freedom from sin and the freedom in order to be a follower of Christ. And I think that is the final lesson of the gospel, wherein the Lord now forgives the woman and tells the woman, your faith has saved you. Go in peace. The forgiveness brings that great freedom to this woman. Freedom from a shameful past. Freedom from her sins. But above all, freedom to be free and to be at peace. And today, yun yung ating kailangan ngayon, di ba? Sa ating lipunan, sa ating mundo ngayon. Yung ating dalin sa Panginoon ang ating mga pagkukulang, ating kasalanan, at hilingin ang kanyang pagpapatawad at paghilom, at hilingin din na tayo ay mapalaya upang ating maisabuhay ang ating pananampalataya sa kanya, to become real and genuine followers of Christ. Today, I invite you to read the gospel, most especially to enter that experience of the woman, the desire for Christ, the desire for Christ's mercy and love and forgiveness, and the freedom of experiencing Christ telling us, your faith has saved you. Go in peace. So today we pray for that. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Placing our confidence in God the Father, who shows loving mercy of His treatment of sinners, we make our prayer, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That church leaders may carry on the work of Jesus in forgiving sins and binding up hearts that are broken, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That a forgiving spirit may lead the people in conflict to a peaceful negotiation, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may be gentle and charitable in our opinion of others, and may we not condemn or reject others on account of their sins and shortcomings. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who are sick, especially those who are affected by the virus, and those who care for them, may experience the healing presence of the Lord through a caring Christian community. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have passed, especially those who have passed and due to the pandemic, may be forgiven by Jesus, our Redeemer. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us also continue to pray for ABS-CBN that the Lord may continue to guide its leaders to discern the future and the new stage of its mission to be in the service of the Filipino. We pray too for all the employees of ABS, those who continue to work and continue the mission, and those and their families who have been retrenched. For them, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Most merciful Father, our prayers come before you in the name of your Son, who loved us and sacrificed himself for our sake. He who is the forgiving Savior, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. To your goodness we have this bread and this wine to offer. Fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this, our sacrifice, may be made acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Look with favor on our supplications, O Lord, and in your kindness accept these your servants' offerings, that what each has offered to the honor of your name may serve the salvation of all through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. With love we celebrate his death. With living faith we proclaim his resurrection. With unwavering hope, we await his return in glory. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, and God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you, especially the community you have gathered here before you in worship, in thanksgiving, and in humble supplication. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. We pray especially for those who died during this time of the pandemic. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with Saint Robert Bellarmine, with the apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us of our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church. And grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you are already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And together let us pray, Oratio Imperata.
God our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem the tide of its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Grant us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We ask for your special providence and protection for the whole world and humanity, our country and our people, our families and our friends. Send your spirit to protect us from this virus. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick,
pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Saint Joseph,
pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Roch,
pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz,
pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod,
pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus,
have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu,
have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy,
have mercy on us.
And let us pray. May the working of this heavenly gift, O Lord, we pray, take possession of our minds and bodies, so that its effects and not our own desires may always prevail in us through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.